Good morning, student. Welcome to online classes on module 4, that is AI train. Okay, so today here we discuss the what is gear train, how the gear trains are classified, and what are its advantages and disadvantages and applications. Okay, and along with that also we today will discuss the what is velocity ratio or what is speed ratio. And the second thing also very important, that is what is train value. Okay, now we will discuss one by one. Now first of all I will go with the definition of gear train. What is gear train first? If the power transmitted by using more than two gears, if the power transmitted using more than two gears, then the arrangement is called as gear trains. So the mainly it is mainly classified into following four types. So these are the following four types. Okay, one is simple gear trains, second is compound gear trains, and third is riveted gear trains, and fourth is epicyclic gear trains. Simple gear train, compound gear train, and riveted gear trains, and fourth one is the epicyclic gear trains. So before going to describe or brief discussion about the classification of gears, first of all we have to know what is velocity ratio and what is speed ratio and what is train value, because these are very important factor before going to understand the classification of gear trains. First we will go with velocity ratio. The velocity ratio is also called as the speed ratio. It is defined as the ratio of angular speed of driver. That is ratio of angular speed of driver gear to the driven gear. Let omega 1 be the angular speed of driver gear and omega 2 be the angular speed of driven gear. Therefore, the velocity ratio, that is omega 1 by omega 2 or N1 by N2, where N1 and N2 are the speed of driver gear and speed of driven gear. Now, second one, that is train value. So, as already said, the train value and velocity ratio are the two important factors before going to describe the classification of gear trains. Okay, now train value. The train value, it is a reciprocal of velocity ratio. The train value is a reciprocal of velocity ratio. It is defined as the angular speed of driven gear to the angular speed of driver gear. Angular speed of driven gear to the angular speed of driver gear. So that is TV equal to angular speed of driver is, that is omega 2 divided by omega 1, or that is equal to N2 by N1. Now we'll go to the classification of gear trains. First, as already said, there are four types of classification of gear trains: simple gear trains, compound gear trains, epicyclic gear trains, and riveted gear trains. First, we'll go with simple gear trains. The simple gear train, each shaft carries only one shaft or only one gear. Each shaft carries only one gear. Second important point about a simple gear train is all gears revolve about the fixed axis. They are revolve about the fixed axis. So this below figure, this figure shows the gear A, gear B, and this is a idler gear. Gear B and gear C. Here omega A is the angular speed of gear A, omega B is the angular speed of gear B, omega C is the angular speed of gear C. So as already said, in simple gear train, each shaft carries only one gear. Gear 1, that is gear A, gear B, that is idler gear B, and gear C, omega C. So next, we will move to the second one, that is compound gear trains. In compound gear trains, each shaft carries two or more gears. Each shaft carries two or more gears except the first and last gear. So compound gear is, each shaft carries two or more gears except the first and last gear, one of which acts as a follower and another acts as a driver, that is driver and another as a driven. So all gears, again here also all the gears revolve about the fixed axis. So this below figure shows the compound gear trains. Compound gear train means gear A, gear B and gear C. As already said, shaft carries two or more gears. So here the shaft A having only one gear, that is called as input gear, and in between having a here we have a gear C and as well as gear B, because center gear consists of two gears, gear B and gear C, and the output gears or driven gears called as the D, gear number D. Okay, now we move to the third kind. So that is third type. Third is riveted gear trains. The riveted trains is the third type of third classification of gear trains. The driver and driven axis lies on the same line, means the driver and driven axle are lies on the same line. So here again two important points. These are used especially, these are used in the speed reducer, clocks and machine tools. These are used specially used in the speed reducer, clocks and machine tools. The one of the another important advantage or application of riveted gear train is center distance of the two pairs of the gear must be same, that is R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4. So now here in the below I will show the how the gear trains are, sorry, riveted gear trains work. So here this is the riveted gear trains. So gear A, gear B and gear C, gear D, or you can say 1, 2, 3 and 4. As already said, the center distance of the riveted gear trains is same. So that is here I written R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4. Now we'll move to the third and last one, that is epicyclic gear train. The epicyclic gear train means one gear revolve upon and around another. Epicyclic means one gears revolve upon and around another. The design involves the planet and sun gears. Planet and sun gears, as one orbits the other like a planet around the sun. The main application, especially in all the automobile sectors, we are using the epicyclic gear train. Special the one, as I already said, the application of epicyclic gear trains, it will hit a huge marine gearbox to a small electric screwdriver. So in all the machine which is ranging from marine gearbox to electric screwdriver, we can use the epicyclic gear train. So here below I will show the picture of typical gearbox. So I will show the below figure shows the typical picture of epicyclic gear train. So this is, as already said, it is one, it is sun and planet. So this is sun and these three are the planets. See here also can show that this is the real picture of epicyclic gear trains which is mounted in a engines. Okay, so this is the classification and application of gear trains. Thank you.